Well, the first reasoning was that I wanted to study physics, so that was really the main goal, so to speak. And then I was looking around for universities that offered physics, and pretty much every university does. So I was thinking, what makes a certain university special? And in Leipzig, that was that they offered physics in English, which I found very interesting because, well, I knew that I was going to go into research, and English is the language of research. And also, I wanted to get to know other people, possibly from foreign countries as well. And as it turned out, that was the case. So it was a good decision.
My reasons were maybe a bit silly. Like after school, I didn't know what I wanted to do, and I thought about either studying physics or English. And then I found this course of studies, which is physics in English, so to speak, and I was immediately convinced that this was like the course
Yeah,
of choice.
that too. Yeah.
Well, during my last year of school, I suddenly decided that like my honors courses in school were English and German, so I didn't really have the physics background, but I became interested in physics and I thought about, well, maybe I could study physics, and then I did a few like lab courses and stuff and worked at physics companies, and after that I decided, well, this is really what I'm interested in, and that's like, I don't know, maybe 3 months before the enrollment deadlines, I decided on physics.
Well, for me, it was a bit different. I had known for quite some time that I wanted to study physics. I think it was some summer school in 2005, maybe or so. And that summer school had the topic of Einstein life and work. And so the guy fascinated me, and what he did fascinated me. So physics it was. And then the choice for Leipzig was because it wasn't too far away from my hometown. So it wasn't that much effort to move there, and so it was still close to home, so that was good. And then, well, they offered it in English, and that was basically when I found out about that was basically the point, when I enrolled, and I think that was 4 months before the semester started or so.
But I think it's mainly interest and passion. That's what you need in order to study physics. I mean, you can get through all the math courses and everything, and through all the basic lectures and everything, if you're motivated enough. What you need is passion for physics. And I don't know, since I started physics, I mean, sometimes on the way you get a bit lost and think, oh, is this really what I want to do? But once you get to the really interesting courses, I don't know, quantum mechanics and the stuff that everyone probably knows a bit about, but you want to know everything about it that there is to know, and that's really inspiring.
Yeah, I was gonna say the same thing basically. So if you're not motivated, you're not gonna make it. But if you are, then there's few things that can stop you. And don't get me wrong, it is hard to study physics, but if you really want it, there's no way you cannot make it. So it's really how much work are you willing to put into studying physics. And in order to do that, you just need to be very motivated. But I mean, that's probably true for studying almost everything.
Yeah, I mean, it's basically like in the first 2 semesters or so, you really think, oh, well, is the effort that I have to put into
Yeah,
this
this is
really
so
worth
hard.
it?
This is so
Yeah,
hard.
does
Why
it
is it
have to
so
be
hard?
that hard? But once you know that you want to do it, then, I mean, it's just, I don't know, explains it for itself, that you just keep on going, yeah. Well, I was surprised that the group was really small. I think we started with like 18 people.
Very small, yeah.
Yeah. But I don't know, so after like the first 2 days or first 3 days, we were already a study group and we knew everyone that was in our course. That was really nice. So you could sit together, do the homework, and I don't know, meet in the evenings, and yeah, it was just like a larger family that had already formed in the first week or so.
Yeah, that was really astonishing. I had not really expected that. And I think that's not very common in other courses of study as either. If you're in a course with 200 people, maybe, you're not gonna get to know everyone equally well. But if you're only 20 people, then that's quite possible. And so we were really a group that stuck together and did pretty much most of the work together as a group. So that was very nice. Well, I was expecting that more of the teachers be from different countries. That was not always the case. That happened more in the later semesters. So in the beginning, it was mostly Germans that gave the courses, which was nice for the Germans in the beginning because maybe you don't know all the words, and then the teacher knows the words in German as well, which might not be the case if it's if the guy's from some other country. I had been expecting more foreign teachers, so to speak, but that came on later, so that wasn't that big of a deal. Most well, I mean, in physics, you have different branches in terms of the topics and also in terms of the style that you do research in. And I think Leipzig is pretty good in a number of branches. So you can do experimental physics pretty well, you can also do theoretical physics pretty well. And in each of those branches, you still have all the different topics. So you can really choose from a pretty wide variety of different research topics. So that was very nice to really be able to choose between things like, semiconductor physics or biophysics or astrophysics. So really all the different scales, from the very big to the very small, you can treat it all, and you can treat it in experiment and in theory. So that was very nice.
I think apart from the academic advantages, so to speak, I really like that there are a lot of cultures in the International Physics Studies program that you get to know. You get to know a bit of, I don't know, Chinese or some other languages, and it's really nice to be able to like sit together, have lunch or dinner together, and every nationality prepare some food, and just you get so many contacts for your later life, for your research life as well, because like they're all stationed or they're all gonna go to other to other nations as well. So you're gonna know someone maybe in the US, maybe in Great Britain or somewhere else. So I think that's also a really big advantage that one shouldn't underestimate. I mean, it's not just the academic stuff, but also the contacts that you form during your studies.
And also, what I think most people realize only later in their studies is if you learn everything in English when you hear it for the first time, that really helps you read, say, current literature, because mostly that's not available in German. And so it makes it really easy if English is kind of your natural language in physics, then that's just, if you read a current work, then that's just in the language that you already know, so to speak. Whereas if you've heard everything in German, that might be harder to get into, so to speak, to get into that language, that thinking in English when talking about physics.
Well, I think the only general misconception that comes to my mind is maybe the image of a physicist that's really, I don't know, introverted
Yeah,
and doesn't talk to
we're
anyone.
not nerds, and that's especially true for the students of this International Physics Studies program. Because, I mean, the people who are there are either from different countries, which means they were willing to go abroad and they were open-minded and they go to a different country to study physics. So for them, that's a lot of effort, and they really had to put work into getting here and doing this. And
Or
for
people that like to travel and get
yeah,
to know different
true, exactly.
cultures and
Exactly.
yeah.
So when we started, for example, most people in our class had been abroad for at least a month or so. So they were all people who had traveled, who had seen and experienced different cultures. And so we at least were not a bunch of nerds who had never seen anything but a computer or a lab, but we were a very open-minded, very open group, very tolerant. And so yeah, it's we're not stereotypical physicists, even though we are physicists.
Stick to it if you really want it.
Hang in there, hang in there. It's hard, but it's getting easier and it's getting more rewarding with every semester that you put into it.
Like at first, it's the question of, do I really want to do that? And then it turns into the question, how much effort do I want to put into it to get good marks or to get a good degree at the end? So it really goes from maybe physics is not right to me, right for me, to, well, I just have to do more and study more, and then I'm gonna make it.
But at some point, you also want to do more, because I mean that's what you want to do. That's gonna be your profession. It's what motivates you. It's what fascinates you. So you're also willing to put in the work, even if it's, you know, sometimes, even if it sometimes feels like it's too much work. But if it's what you love, then it's not that hard.
Well, after my IPSP bachelor, I continued with the IPSP master here at Leipzig. And after my master's degree, I'll probably, I don't know, start the PhD.
Yeah, for me it was pretty much the same. So I finished my bachelor's degree, and then I went abroad for a year, and now we're both finishing up our master's degrees, basically. And then I want to do a PhD as well. I don't know where yet. Maybe here, maybe in some other places. And yeah, I mean, there's a lot of possibilities, so...